Have you ever heard of the Health Cup? Probably not, but I'm sure you've heard of the Dixie Cup. My fondest memory of the Dixie Cup is when I was a kid growing up in Ohio. Our schools used to have us do these fluoride swishes. Some kid would be appointed the privilege of going out and getting a tray full of Dixie Cups filled with this fluoride swill. The kid would come back into class, walk around, we'd all grab our Dixie Cups, throw them in our mouth, swish, and spit. Anybody else remember this? If so, leave a comment. Could you imagine doing something like this, but instead of everyone having individual Dixie Cups, there was just one communal cup that every kid would wrap their mouth around and take their fluoride magic? Gross, right? Well, that's sort of the problem that the Dixie Cup set out to solve. It was invented in 1907 by Boston attorney inventor Lawrence Llewellyn. He was hoping to stop the spread of communal disease with his little paper cups. You see, at that time in history, people were tin cupping. In other words, if you went to a public place, there would be one tin cup that everyone would use. And if that sounds gross, it's because it was. Hundreds of people would use these tin cups daily to drink out of. And I'm sure you can imagine what sort of negative health implications would come along with that. So the company that produced the Health Cup, later to become the Dixie Cup, grew kind of ishly over the next 10 years. Until 1918, something happened, something big. Do you remember your history? The flu. It was the influenza of 1918, a global pandemic. And suddenly the Health Cup became a paper-based, simple bit of life-saving packaging technology. No more tin cupping. The world needed single-use cups because at that time there was no vaccine, there was no medicine for the flu. So tactics like isolation, quarantine, good personal hygiene, use of disinfectants, and limitations of public gatherings were employed to stop the spread. Sounds kind of familiar. So what's the point of all this? Packaging helped save the day. So what innovations will you bring to the table during these trying times? The packaging industry is in the spotlight as the world is looking for ways to combat the coronavirus and stay healthy in general. There's PPE, food packaging, e-commerce, so many packaging-related things that can help save the day again. So keep on innovating. And also, keep calm, carry on, and wash your hands. See you next time.